Alright, this is going to be the first video of the 28-gallon JBJ Nano progression series. I'm just going to give you a quick run through of the setup and, you know, a few pieces of the equipment. Currently, this tank's been running 3.5 months. And basically, we just got through our ugly phase for the most part. I do have the lights set on all white just so that way you guys can see. It does have a little bit of a disco effect whenever the lights are all on white like it is. Currently, when I run the blues, it's not nearly as bad. So, real quick run through of everything. On this tank, I am running a Aquamax Bullet 1 protein skimmer. It is a nice protein skimmer. It fits very well into the sump. And I definitely really enjoy it. Creates a good skim mate. I am also running the Reef LED 50 mate by Red Sea. And then I am running the AquaSmart ATO Micro auto top off system. Obviously, you can see the sensor down in there. And then I have a 5-gallon reservoir down in the sump for it. Or in the stand, I'm sorry. And then, last but not least, I'm running the MP10 wave maker. It is not the quiet drive, so you're probably hearing it in the background. I keep it on a pulse mode at about 70%, 80% right now for the time being, until my spin streams get here that I ordered to replace those outbound nozzles. And then I will probably turn it down once I can get a little bit more of an erratic wave pattern. Now keep in mind, this is all whites and no blues, so a lot of the color isn't going to pop like it normally would. Right now, I do have 5 fish in total, as you can see, a couple of the premium oscillarias. A couple of people have said that they're gladiators, but I don't believe so. If you look at their helmet as she comes by, I don't really think it's a gladiator. When you look at the pictures, a couple of Mangi cardinals. And then the orange spotted goby that likes to hide in the Zoa garden. He does come out and run around and nibble on the rocks. Few different red-footed snails and hermit crabs right now. As far as my aquascape goes, I tried to do a negative scape as best as I could with the design that I wanted. You know, I tried to keep minimal footings on the floor. If you can see all the way around, that's the back. Tried to leave myself some space everywhere for maximum water flow, trying to eliminate any potential dead spots. And it seems to be working so far pretty well. Ignore the vinegar, well, the residue from cleaning the tank last night. Or glass, I should say. Currently, it seems to be doing really well. I used the Life Rock. So it would have more of a matured look. I did in the last tank, the 180 that I had for a couple years. It turned out amazing over the years. I wish I would have done more videos. But I did use pure dry rock. And when we say pure dry rock, I mean that white, you know, extremely cleaned. It took forever to get some coralline algae starting to form on it. So I thought I would go with something a little more mature looking. I will say that this rock seems to have finally started or stopped leaching, and I do believe it leached some silicates into the system because it took a little longer to get the tank cycled than it seemed like it did with the regular dry rock. Real quick rundown on the few corals that I have in here at the moment. There is an elegance coral. A lot of people want a full striped elegance. I wish I had the blues on so you could see how pretty everything looks. But, you know, for right now, until I get my new lens, I'm just going to have to deal with that. But I like the ones that have the bare spots in them. I don't like them fully green. I like a little broken pattern. So it took me a minute to find one that I liked, but I did like her very much. And so I got her. There is also a frog spawn coral. euphilia. The frog spawn is mostly the reason why I'm going to the spin streams, because with these nozzles that come with these, you know, they're directional. You can point them anywhere, but you know, it's almost like having two more power heads blasting a torpedo effect onto the tank, and I don't like that. I want, you know, obviously a broken or an irregular water flow pattern, so we can get a little more sway as opposed to them getting or her getting blasted. And then we got the beginning of the Zoa garden here. They're just a mix of little everything right now. I got a few more coming. If the blues were on, you could see it better, but there are some Rastas, some Fruit Loops, some pink diamonds, some chaos or utter chaoses. You know, there's the, I forget what they're called, purple monsters or whatever they are. There's a few different ones in there. I don't know if I said the eagle eyes. There's some eagle eyes in there. But basically, this is my setup for the time being. As we progress, I'll try to update it about once a month. This is my third tank. The 180 I did love, don't get me wrong. But me, I like nanos. I'm not going to lie to you. The large tanks are great. You got a lot less of a challenge when it comes to, you know, biological warfare, any kind of, you know, contaminants. You know, you got the dilution ratio. But, you know, I like nano. I really do. I'm a big nano fan. I like the challenge that comes with it. And, you know, I also like just the compact look. And obviously the cost is a lot less for a nano in a sense, depending what you're going to do. But I would say I've pretty much got about $1,500 to $2,000 already wrapped up into this tank. So, I mean, when you take it in consideration, yeah, you're going to have less troubles with a large aquarium. But with a smaller aquarium, it presents a challenge. And when it comes to your corals and stuff, you are limited because you're limited on space. So you have to really decide how you want to do it, and just stick with a plan. Obviously, you can go off of the plan a little bit, but just have a basis and foundation for what you're going to do over time. So I hope that you guys enjoy this tank as it progresses as much as I will. Definitely hit the like and subscribe button, and hit the bell so you can be notified whenever I post new videos. And then as we progress, I would love for everybody to learn from my mistakes, comment where you think there could be improvements. And this is Salty Steve signing out.